Now, going to the dentist does more than just protect you from cavities. It can actually end up catching certain cancers. April is Head and Neck Cancer Awareness Month. Today, Rick Gill is here to talk about oral cancers. He is a head and neck oncology navigator at Cone Health Cancer Center, Wesley Long Hospital. Good morning.
Thank you.
First off, let's talk about the job title, a navigator. You, I guess, help people through this process, right?
Right. I'm one of eight navigators at the Cone Health Cancer Center, and each of us works with a specific diagnostic group. So when somebody comes into the cancer center with a head and neck cancer, I'm their contact person, and I walk the journey with them throughout their treatments and then for months afterwards.
Let's talk specifically about head and neck cancers. I guess, are they harder to detect than other types of cancer, or what?
Well, actually, as any cancer, you know, earlier detection is better. But oral cancers are fairly easy to detect. They occur in the region that we call the oropharynx. So they're cancers that are found in the mouth, the cheeks, the gum line, on the tongue, on the tonsils, but also back to into the throat area on the epiglottis, which is that flap that covers your windpipe, as well as your vocal cords.
So once you detect something like that, talk about the process. You know, how do people, you know, get through? Are surgeries or treatments better than they used to be?
Well, there are chemotherapy and radiation are the mainstay treatments, but it's important to know that to prevent oral cancers, to begin with, avoiding all tobacco products is important, and also excessive alcohol can be a source of oral cancers. More recently, the HPV virus, or human papillomavirus, has been identified as an agent of oral cancers. Usually HPV is associated with cervical cancer in women, but it has been shown that HPV can cause oral cancers in both men and women. Usually when you're exposed to HPV, the body's immune system is able to rid it of that virus, but in some instances that virus can remain dormant or cause a cancer years, even decades after exposure.
We started off talking about a trip to the dentist, a trip to the doctor, though. If you've got some pain or something's not right, it's not something to just say, well, I'll get better. It's worth asking a doctor about, right?
Absolutely. There are symptoms and signs of oral cancers that everybody should be aware of. Certainly a persistent mouth sore, throat soreness, difficulty swallowing. An earache or hoarseness can be signs of an oral cancer. But it's important for your viewers to understand that these are also symptoms of other illnesses. General rule of thumb is that if they persist for more than 2 weeks, you should call your primary care physician and see them as soon as possible. Also speaks to the importance of seeing your dentist twice a year. Your oral hygienist and dentist are very much in tune and trained to identify oral cancers at their early stages.
When you talk about that healthcare chain, every link in it is very important.
Absolutely.
What's an age group? Can they basically affect people of all ages, or what?
Typically what we've been seeing is the oral cancers develop, and we see folks in their mid-40s to their early 80s. To avoid the cancers, it's really important to avoid all tobacco products. And we're going to include e-cigarettes in that right now, because we just don't know enough about e-cigarettes to know for sure. And avoiding alcohol. It's with the increase of HPV-associated cancers, it's highly recommended that individuals get, preteens and young adults, get the HPV vaccine. When children, boys and girls, ages 11, 12, get the vaccine, their body has an opportunity to develop immunity, so that if they're exposed in later life, then their bodies can rid it. It's been shown too that young men up to the age of 21 and women up to the age of 26 can gain some benefit also from the vaccine.
Okay, well, thank you very much for telling us about it. We appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Always very topical. As we said, this is Head and Neck Cancer Awareness Month. Learn more at Cone Health's March Cancer Education Center, including an issue that patients face and therapies too. You can go Wednesday, April 11th, noon to 1 at the Cancer Center in Alamance Regional, or Monday, April 16th, 6 to 7 at the Cancer Center in Greensboro. To register for either of those, go to conehealth.com/classes or call the number on your screen, 336-832-8000.
House Call on Fox 8 is sponsored by Cone Health.